Welcome to the MEP Academy. In this video, we're going to cover how to calculate the total BTUs of water using the formula Q equals GPM times 500 times the delta T. All right, I'm going to show you how to calculate the total BTUs of water. This can be used on anything where you can measure the flow and the delta T. So the formula is BTUs per hour equal your GPM, that's your flow of water, times 500, which is a constant, we won't get into that, times your entering water temperature minus your leaving water temperature. So the equation is used to calculate BTUs, and you can also move the formula around to determine GPM if you already know the BTUs of a waterside piece of equipment. So for our sample here, we're going to say that we got a chiller, a water-cooled chiller, and we've measured 400 GPM. And looking at the gauges or the thermometers, we got 57 degrees of entering water temperature. That would be our chilled water returned coming back from the air handlers or the fan coils. And our leaving water temperature gauge, our chilled water supply, shows 45 degrees. That's the water going out to the air handler and going out to the fan coils. So looking at our chiller, we got the 400 GPM. We got the 57 degree entering water temperature for chilled water return. 45 degree chilled water supply. That gives us a delta T, the difference in temperature between the supply and the return of 12 degrees. So the 400 GPM is our flow, and our 12 degrees is the delta T, the temperature difference between supply and return. With those values, we can come up with the tonnage of this chiller. So the equation is BTUs per hour equal GPM times 500 times the delta T. So we measured 400 GPM. We got 500 times the entering water temperature was 57, that's chilled water return, minus 45 degrees chilled water supply, which gives us a delta T of 12. You multiply this out, 400 times 500 times 12, it gives you 2,400,000 BTUs. That's equivalent to, because we know in each ton, there are 12,000 BTUs. So you take the 2,400,000, and you divide it by 12,000 to get the quantity of tons. So that is a 200-ton chiller. That chiller is rated for 200 tons. It's a simple formula, and you can turn it around and determine GPM if you know the BTUs. So this is a quick way to determine the tonnage of whatever waterside piece of equipment you're measuring if you have the GPM and the delta T. Subscribe for additional videos. We will be covering mechanical, electrical, and plumbing estimating, engineering, installation and fabrication best practices for mostly commercial construction and some residential.